Okay, so I'm assuming this stream is gonna work. This is an official match between Water Taste and the Templars. Rules are as follows. We have, I don't know those limits, but we have three heavies as the starting limits. We have MMR, Necro's disabled, and Ninja Capping is disallowed. And Ninja Holding is also disallowed. So starting off here, we have Water Taste on the offense as the blue team, and Templars are the red team. Good assassination there for the game. They seem to have really good defense at the start of this first map. Over on the other side, we see Lady Rogue as Archer. And we have a mage here who is Slasher. Akali is Swainwu. Siwu. As the offense for the Templars, we got Public. We have Deuce, who's playing as this guy right now. And we have Peas. Public gets headshot with his Archer. Nothing is really seeming to going on right now. Nothing exciting, at least. Because this is really a defensive-based map. I think this was Water Taste's pick. I'm pretty sure. We also have Boss as the archer for the Templars. We have some offense coming in now for Water Taste. Snow Leak is also the pyro. Their offense doesn't seem to be very coordinated right now. He is Chemist, he is not gonna get out. Snow Leak does get the recovery and the frenzy off of Eugene. Meanwhile, we have Water Taste kind of struggling to stay together as Raging and Boss are kind of ganging up on them. Okay, we are back to normal. If you saw a black screen, that's because I just have my home window disabled. So sorry for that. Alright. Nothing really going on right now. No one has really stolen the flag and gone out very far. Again, this is a very defensive-based map. So I think Water Taste is trying to tie here, or maybe just get one cap, and then probably turtle for the rest of the game. Assuming that this is their map pick. So I am assuming the Templars picked Pagodas or Lowrise as their choice. We see Darius has the flag. It's not going to get very far, and Mike will recover that. Their offense doesn't really seem to be coordinated. As I said earlier, they just seem to be kind of clustered around.5 minutes have almost gone by and nothing has really happened other than a couple of really quick stings. Shadow Luna does kill Eugene right there in a very nice combo. Gets headshot by Boss, as he is in a very nice hiding spot there. Medic is gonna go after him. about to get some support from Luna. The medic might die here. Let's see, the medic will die first. And, oh, ninja died first. And yeah, the medic died. Boss probably has very low health right now. Meanwhile, the assassin's still hiding. The hero. I don't know if they have friends or not, can't tell because they don't have their backs out right now. The Templar's offense, I don't think they're getting really anywhere. Which is kinda disappointing. But yet again, this is a very defensive base map. So you kinda have to be a bit coordinated. The assassin does die, but the mage is giving the TC a very hard time. That's the trick. Very nice job from the roaming water taste side. Alright. We do have a steal by the Templars. It was November. He's actually out of this order. He is out. Don't know about his health though. Seems to be moderately low. Considering he's been on fire 2 times. The medic is right there. He seems to be pretty low though. He's gonna take the risk. Ooh. And Lucky Judge gets the recovery right before the medic, which is a good thing for them. Around this side we have a 1v1 archer, boss, and Lady Rope. Red flag, it's not really doing much. Blue flag, anything going on here? Not really. Do some peas together. And engage again. November steals the flag, but does get frenzied there. Nicely done by the pyro. Deuce has the flag. The pyro could get him. The mage doesn't see this, which is kind of upset. We'll get the heal. Ooh. Probably a headshot? Couldn't tell. But nicely done there. Probably just died of poison, I couldn't tell. Lady Rock ends boss's 15 kill streak. Wow. And we are almost 9 minutes into this first map. So nothing much has really happened, other than a couple of steals, one major one, but that was the recovery. Deuce seems to be struggling just a tiny bit. November does steal the flag, but does get that frenzy. Pavlik struggling, and he does die to the heavy there. I think he is one of the latest additions to the Templars. And also Raging is a more recent member. Good job by the pyro there to focus on one of the soldiers. November thought he stole it at first, but then he had to go back. Now he's struggling to get out, and this might be a kill, which it is. Missed time delay there, which is unfortunate. But it happened. Let's look at the defense for the Templars. They only have one person defending, which is Darius. Does steal, but I lost the game and got recovery on that. Didn't really get far. Yeah, Lartace's offense is very dispersed. There's only like a few going in at a time. Meanwhile, we do have November stealing again. He is... Oh, he's gonna make it out of the flag. He should be careful though. He's probably ran on a medic. And then just gonna give him a hard time. Seems to get a bit farther than he was on his first attempt when he got out. He's going for the trees, using soldiers to his advantage. The medic is right there. He could get the heal. I don't know if he got the regen or not. November is about to get the full regen. He does. He's taking the sponge. This might be a cap for TT. Because I don't think that they can recover it. This is definitely a good team game, so good job by November then to get the first guy for the match. Baked on us. Okay, never mind that. Meanwhile, after all that drama, Templar's offense seems to be regrouping again. Another attempt. The par is gonna be a main issue here, unless they could kill it really quickly. Steal by Water Taste. Oh, that's an interesting way to get out. He is out. Very low though, I would imagine. I don't see their medic anywhere, and he's surrounded. And that's gonna be a recovery by Raging. Could have been a pickup, but it wasn't. They should try to hurry up and get this flag ASAP. Put some pressure. Raging's doing a fantastic job of keeping them out of the flag. Very nice job there. Meanwhile, boss is still archer at mid. He's basically have both sides to this map. While Lartace's archer is basically just a defensive archer, which I think is a disadvantage for them. Boss seems to be more in control, can see both sides, and he's doing some fantastic headshots right now. Templar's offense seems to be a bit dispersed at the moment, but could get a bit more organized in a little bit. It is currently 1-0 Templars at the moment. Deuce does steal the flag. He is soldier. He is about to get out. He's waiting on the medic. I think he got the regen there. Might get the full heal, which he does. Very nice whip there by Slasher. Both Slashers are getting on Deuce. Deuce almost went off the map, but he did die poisoning. Don't know if someone's gonna pick that up. Oh, November might. But Slasher gets there on time. That's DT, by the way, the one with the underscore. The main focus right now is if Huertes could tie this. I don't think they will. There's just under 4 minutes remaining in this first map. Templar's offense is just attacking. Steals the flag. Trying to get the medic. I think he will. Does he get the whole heal? So Deuce is out. He is struggling a lot though. And he has got. Oh, not quite. Almost. Now he's dead. So, Eugene steals the flag. He is out. He should have passed it off there, to be completely honest. Now he has to probably try to get across this map. He is out. He is far though. He might get headshot, but he doesn't have support at all. He's all solo at the moment. Being pressured by the ninja and raging. And then we'll get fronted there for the recove by Snowleak. Pavlik does steal the flag. I don't know where that flag was. Oh, it's right there. And they get a recovery. Just 2 minutes now before this first map ends. Very good effort by the Huertes defense to not make sure that they capitalize, but I could be jinxing that. As Nomara does get a steal right here. He is out. He does have Deuce as support. He is going to try to pass it though. Oh, well that was a very close call there. That could have been easy recovery. But a great web there by Slasher, and a good frenzy by the Pyro for a combo recove there. So it looks like it's going to remain 1-0 for the rest of the period, for now. Also being pressured by the ninja here. And just die to the archer. Just over 30 seconds left, and this looks like it's gonna be a good game. So 1-0 the final score for the Templars for this first map. Eugene does get a steal, but there's going to be time running out, and that's going to be game. So, I don't know what the next map is. I'm assuming it's Pagodas. Could be anything, but we will have to see. And it is Blackout. Alright. It's a very interesting map choice. I know that the Templars can do very well on this map. Sometimes they will have their struggles. Same thing goes with Water Taste, but I know they do struggle a bit on this map, so I think this favors TT a lot more. So this is just about to start. Second map, this is Blackout. So some very interesting changes here. I think that Raising's gonna be a defensive roaming soldier, which is kind of what you want on this map if you're playing defense. Meanwhile, War Taste looks a bit disorganized. The Slasher, or DT in this case, sorry. DT is Mage. I'm assuming that they know that he's there. That lightning went the they wanted. Snowlake does steal the flag though. Gets out comparatively clean. Ooh, does get frozen there in the air. Good job there by the mage. And does die to the pirate. Meanwhile, Deuce does get the flag. Medic. Is right behind the mage. He's gonna try to go all the way across the map and does not get there in time. Does die to the mage or the assassin, I believe. I think that's one advantage for the War Taste defense is that mage. Meanwhile, Eugene does steal the flag. Doesn't get very far, dies to either Luna. Someone else, but Luna does recover the flag there. And November is now the Pyro, which is a very interesting change. So normally I see him on Ninja defense. Again, the War Taste Archer here is playing very defensively, where Boss is just in his normal, comfortable zone at mid, trying to get all the offense that he can. I think that's where the War Taste Archer should be. To be honest, Snowlake does get a steal, dies to the Pyro, and Deuce also dies to the Pyro. Very good reaction time there for the Pyro. None of them can steal it because they're not close enough. Darius does get it. Does die to Raging though, and he does a good recovery there. Right after getting it. He's struggling to get the flag. So, I think it would have been smarter for the medic to steal. Does kill the mage, but does die to the assassin right afterward. So nothing really going on in this first 4 minutes here. Stealing covers. Here is Snowlake though, does get headshot. Peace picks up. Might die here, he is in a bit of a corner. Does die to the mage. Nicely done. Which does die to the frenzy. Darius picks up the flag after a steal. He is going spawn side, but does get headshot by boss. Very nicely done. Eugene doesn't really see the flag, which is kind of interesting. Does get headshot as well there. Kind of surprised that no one has capped me yet. I think they're both playing very defensively right now. Not really sending that many people on offense. Spectator glitches. Alrighty. Slasher again is a very big part of this Warataste defense. Eugene also stole the flag. He is struggling a little bit. He might die here. There is no medic anywhere to be found. I don't know where their medic is. Snowleak does steal the flag. Does seem to have very low health, and the frenzy is a big part of that. Yikes. Don't know where their medic is, they really should have the medic. And the medic does die in rage, it does recover there. Deuce, on the other hand, does get the steal. He is struggling in a different direction. The mage dies to the assassin there, which is good. Ooh, that's not good. Let's try to play a flag, slowly place it. No weapon can cross slowly. Darius does have the flag. He's getting very far, actually. He's about to go over the bars. And we are about to have a stalemate here. So Snowleak has it as soldier, and Darius has it as soldier. But TT's already putting pressure. I want to say that Warataste will lose this stalemate. Especially because they got boss pressure right there, and no one is pressuring on boss. TT side. They don't really have a medic, which is interesting. Snowleak does have the flag. Let's see here. Raging comes in. Probably will die to the pyro. I want to say that the pyro now has frenzy. Hulk's about to come in. Meanwhile, nothing's really going on. Templar's finally in the medic. Oh, Darius drops it. Probably got headshot or something. Oh, he did get headshot. Slasher is now medic. They're most likely going to pass. Darius picks it up. Keep in mind, if a map does tie right now, the Templars will have a one cap advantage. But if the Templars win here, then it's all over. 10 minutes are almost gone by for blackout. Nothing is really happening right now, which is a shame. But that's kind of one of the things you would expect from a Stanley special. I do have some action here, but all of the Templars does die very fast. Ooh, where is that hedgehog? That's a great hedgehog. I think boss just died literally right after. This could be a recovery for TT. Oh, it was so close. If Luna came in 1 second earlier, she would have had that recovery. Meanwhile, on the Templar side, they seem to be all fine. Templars are putting so much pressure on them that all of the Water Taste people are just supporting the flag carrier right now, it seems. Archer is about to get in position though. Does die to the pyre there. To those 3 or 4 people who are watching the stream, thanks for tuning in. We highly appreciate it, especially because we're a bit disorganized this Saturday. I'm not really supposed to be commentating, but I guess I am, so I apologize if I'm doing a really bad job. But thank you for tuning in to MSW today. Ooh, November does get the recovery there. That's a good job by November. And Templars will get the first cap halfway through. That's nicely done there. So we're just halfway through the map now. TT is leading by one cap yet again, but this time if time runs out, they will win the match because it's the best of three maps. They do struggle there a bit. Eugene is trying to get out, but he's also struggling a bit. Does kill the pirate though, but gets headshot by boss. Snowleak on the other hand gets a good steal, got out, and the medic respawned. He is over the bars. This might be a second cap for the Templars. Meanwhile, Avidus has the flag, has little to no support. Their medic is nowhere to be seen. Oh, there they are. They do get a good heal there, and this might lead it to another stalemate unless boss could headshot them. Good chance, he does not get it. The pyro is right there though, so that could lead to a frenzy. Oh, and it does, and Raging does get the recovery there. Nicely done by November. Snowleak is about to capture for the second time. Very nicely done by him. Darius seems to have the flag. A soldier? He is basically doing the same. Does die. Eugene was kind of waiting for him to die, which is kind of weird. Normally you would support your flag carrier. He is out. Does get headshot though by boss. Nicely done by him. Deuce also has the flag. He's not catching up on that. Very nicely done there by the archer to headshot them both. Both Deuce and Snowleak. Just a bit over 12 minutes remaining. Snowleak, the flag. Pirate does seem to have frenzy, but is not focusing on Snowleak enough. He is at mid, got the medic, he got the full resort. He's going straight down mid, and this is going to be a third cap for the Templars. Very nicely done by Snowleak once again. This time Deuce has the flag. Does die though. Avidus is going straight down mid, just like Snowy did that last time. But a nice web there by Bees. Don't know if that was a regen. Might have been. Avidus might get headshot here. Should be very careful. It's kind of going backwards, which is kind of a shame. Should have just kept going forward. Probably would have saved it. He does pass a Darius though, which is interesting. They might get a headshot here. Still struggling. frenzy does eventually kill Darius. Eugene once again stays in the flag. Don't know why he did that. But he is out. Got launched into the fountain there. And dies to the next game. Vius steals it and he is with Darius. This is a good thing. I don't see their medic though. The medic seems to be nowhere. And this could be a cap. Oh, the pyro is right there. Almost died. Get their first cap. Nicely done there by Vius to get the first cap away at least. Eugene steals, dies immediately. Snowy also stole, dies immediately as well. Frenzy kills Deuce. Wartaze is doing a pretty decent job to not let this go like a low blow. Kind of immediately. They're doing a nice defensive job. Same with the Templars, but they're doing a lot better. And it's shown in the scoring. Eugene does get a steal. Boss does die, which is interesting. Eugene is out. Eugene was able to hit Eugene back. Eugene's struggling right now. He's about to die. It's a very nice punch there by Raging. Vius does have to. Don't know if that was a ninja or an assassin. Does die to Luna. They don't really seem to have a good medic for Wartaze at the moment, which is kind of a shame. But Deuce will probably get this cap right here. Very nice job by him. Just under 7 minutes remaining. Don't really know if Wartaze can tie it. Highly doubt it, but we'll see. Die there, and Mac dies right afterward. Eugene does steal it. He is out. Taking the edge there, I don't know if he stopped. Seems to struggle a bit. That. Dies to Luna. Darius gets a steal. player seems to be taking the side. We'll probably get this medic. Meanwhile, Deuce does have a flag. Let's see. Oh, he's about to cap it. And this might be it. And now it is. Alright, so very nice job there by the Templars. Final score 1-0 on the first map for TT. Final score for the second map 5-1 to TT. So overall 2-0 win for TT.